Hi friends, today I am going to discuss UGC-NET Compressions and Applications Part 7. In previous video, I have already discussed Part 1, Part 2, Part 3, Part 4, Part 5, Part 6. If you want that video, kindly go to my channels. And also, you follow this tag, hashtag UGC-NET Paper 2, hashtag UGC-NET 10 Years Solution, hashtag NTNet, hashtag UGC NET exam, hashtag NET JRF, hashtag NET, hashtag JRF, hashtag UGC NET, hashtag UGC 10 year solution. If you want more videos, kindly like and subscribe and press the bell icon. Now today I am going to discuss next questions. First question, a recursive function is H is defined as follows. H of m equal to k if m equal to 0, 1 if m equal to 1, 2h m minus 1 plus 4h m minus 2 if m greater than equal to 2. If the value of h for equal to 88, then the value of k is, we can calculate using here h of 0 equal to k, h of 1 equal to 1. It is given in the questions. Next, h2 equal to 2h1 plus 4h0 equal to 2 plus 4k. We substitute this value. Then again, if I calculate the h3 using h2 and h1, that is 2h2 plus 4h1 equal to 2 into 2 plus 4k plus 4, that is 8 plus 8k. And then we calculate the h4 using h1, h2, h3, that is 2h3 plus 4h2 equal to 2 into 8 plus 8k plus 4 into 2 plus 4k equal to 16 plus 16k plus 8 plus 16k equal to 24 plus 32k. That is h4 equal to 24 plus 32k, and value of h4 given for 88. We put this value and we calculate the value of k, and that is the answer becomes 2. Next question. Suppose that there are n stations in a slotted line. Each station attempt to transit with a probability p in each of time slot. The probability that only one station transmits is given by is. We know that station transmit is mutually exclusive. That is, when one station transmit, other station will be void. Probability for station transmit equal to nc1 p1 into 1 minus p into 1. That is equal to n into p into 1 minus p whole to the power n minus 1. This is the answer. Next question. A station A uses 32 byte packets to transit. A station A uses 32 byte packets to transit message to station B using sliding window protocol. The round trip delay between A and B is 40 milliseconds. The bottleneck bandwidth or path between A and B is 64 kbps. The optimal window size A is, we calculate using the formula. The round trip delay equal to 40 milliseconds equal to 40 into 10 to the minus 3 seconds. We convert it into seconds. Bottleneck bandwidth equal to 64 kbps equal to 64 into 10 to the 3 bits. That is, we convert into bits. Total data equal to 64 into 10 to the 3 into 40 into 10 to the 3, 10 to the minus 3, we can substitute this value. We get 64 into 40 equal to 2560 bits, and convert into byte, 2560 by 8 equal to 320 bytes. That is, the optimal window size equal to 320 by 20 equal to 10. This is the answers. Next question. Let GX be the generator polynomial used for CRC. CRC means cyclic redundancy checking. The condition that should be satisfied by GX to correct odd number error bits will be, answer should be 1 plus x is a factor of GX. Next question. In a packet switching network, if a message size is 48 byte and each packet contains a header of 33 bytes, if 24 packets are required to transmit a message, the packet size is, the answer should be 24 packet requires carrying 48 bytes of data. So each packet carries 48 by 24 equal to 2 bytes of data. Each packet has 3 bytes of header. So packet size equal to 3 plus 2 equal to 5 bytes. Next question. A node X is a 10 Mbps network is regulated by a token packet. The token packet is filled at a rate of 2 Mbps. Token packet is initially filled with 16 megabits. The maximum duration taken by X transmit at full rate of 10 Mbps is that second. We calculate it using this formula. Capacity of token packet equal to 68 Mbps. Maximum possible transmit rate equal to 10 Mbps. So maximum burst time equal to 60 by 10 minus 2 equal to 2 Mbps. This is the answer. Next question. The minimum number of scalar multiplication required for parentizations of matrix chain product whose sequence of dimension of 4 matrix is 5, 10, 3, 12, 5 is. The minimum number of scalar multiplications equal to 5 into 10 into 3 plus 3 into 12 into 5 plus 5 into 3 into 5 equal to 150 plus 180 plus 75 equal to 405. This is the answer. Next question. A software project was estimated at 352 function points or FP. A four-person team will be assigned to the project consisting of an architect, two programmers and a tester. The salary of the architect is 80,000 per month. Rupees per month, the programmer 60,000 per month, the tester 50,000 per month. The average productivity for the team is 8 FP per person month. Which of the following represent the project cost of the project? Total 352 FP, average 8 FP per person per month, total 8 for total 4 persons. The average productivity equal to 352 by 8 into 4 equal to 11. The project cost of the project 80,000 plus 2 into 60,000 plus 50,000 into 11 equal to 275,000. Next question. A memory management system has 64 pages with 512 bytes page size. Physical memory consists of 32 page frame. Number of bits required in logical and physical address are respectively. Logical address equal to 2^6 into 2^9 equal to 2^15. So 15 bits. And physical address equal to 2^5 into 2^9 equal to 2^14. That is 14 bits. Next questions. Let C be a binary error code. Binary linear code with minimum distance 2t plus 1. Then it correct up to dash bits of error. That is t bits of error. Next question. A t error correct in q-nary linear code satisfy. So m into summation of I equal to 0 to 2. Nci q minus I equal to I less than equal to x. Where m is the number of code words and x is m into p to the n summation of I equal to 0 to t nci 1 minus 1 by q whole to the y less than equal to x or qn. If you like my videos, kindly subscribe and press the bell icon. Next questions. Let R is be the two fuzzy set operations. R equal to x1, y1, y1, y2. This is the matrix 0, 6, 0, 4, 0, 0.6, 0, 0.4, 0, 0.7, 0, 0.3. And is equal to y1, y2, 0, z2, z3. There is 0.8, 0.5, 0.1, 0.0, 0.6, 0.4. In the resulting relation T, which relates elements of universe X to elements of universe Z, whose is in maximum minimum correspondingly. We know that for minimum value, we calculate the value of we put this value fuzzy relations and we get the answer is this value, that is R into S, that is 0.6 and 0.8. We get the minimum value, that is 0.6 and 0.4. We get the value 0.5, 0.6. That is a minimum value 0.5. And proceeding in this way, we to create the matrix. If you like more videos, then subscribe it. And we again meet in the next video. Thank you very much.